is like what they have to do. It's about connecting the cells in parallel. We'll start in 5 minutes. I will just list the topics. It's about connecting cells in parallel. So it's, we'll see the parallel combination of cells. Parallel combination of cells. This is what we have to do. Followed by some few problems. Okay. Problems based on the parallel combination of cells.
Hello.
Yes, madam. Good evening, madam.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Students not yet joined, it seems.
I'm just writing the, I think one student is there. I'm just writing the thing. What I am going to discuss. Not started.
Go ahead, sir. 3-4 minutes are there. At sharp at 4, we can start, sir.
Yeah, no problem, madam. I'm just writing the list of the things so that students will see that.
Sure. Okay, sir. Okay. Carry on. Thank you, sir.
Okay. So the next one is like N cells of same EMF E connected in parallel. How does that work? The fourth one is like there is one question on the something called mixed grouping. The mixed grouping part they may not ask. That's next one. If possible, we do the fifth topic as electrical power. That would be the fifth one. That much we can do later, followed by we have to do meter bits. That's followed by potential meter. Meter bits, potential meter. Okay. And see how far I can cover. I'm not sure. Maybe by the next class, we can complete this particular chapter. Then we can move ahead with the next one will be electric charges and electric fields. Whether everyone have them? Okay, no, not yet. Okay, we'll start now. So I'll just recap the things what I have to do. Only one Ashwini is there. Okay, we'll recap the things. There are N cells. They are connected with an EMF, each of EMF E. They are having internal resistance. Internal resistance of small r, they are connected. So in series, they are connected in series. So the situation is like you have like this, and again E and internal resistance R, and it's E and internal resistance R. So it's like this, they are connected in series. E and internal resistance R, like this, they are connected in series core. Now what will be the E equivalent? The equivalent EMF will be N E, and the equivalent resistance will be NR. This is what we have discussed in the earlier class. Now the situation is, this is a situation of series combination of cells. This is a situation of series combination of cells. The cells are connected in series combination. Now, how come we have to do the parallel combination? Now we need to deal with the, everyone joining, I hope. Oh, good point. So the now I'm just recapping the things. Okay, so we have to see the parallel combination of cells. So now the topic today is parallel combination of cells. How do we get parallel combination of cells? So how do we do that? So consider a simple scenario of this kind. Like one cell of EMF E1 with an internal resistance of R1 and another cell of EMF E2 with R2. Okay, internal resistance R2, they are connected like this along. Okay, now how do you define the parallel combination? Is that plus is connected to plus, connected to plus, and minus is connected to minus. If you see such scenario, then you will say it is parallel combination. Now let's check this one. Now this is the positive end, this is negative end, this is positive end, and this is negative end of the cell. Now this positive is connected to positive, and this negative is connected to negative. In such situation, when you see, this is called, it is called parallel combination of cells. Now for this, we'll write directly the EMF formula directly. Then the EMF formula, that is sufficient. The EMF formula will be the effective EMF. This is called effective EMF, is given by E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 divided by 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. You have to remember this formula. This is a little bit difficult to remember, but you have to remember this. So this is the effective EMF, effective EMF, E effective is given by this formula. Similarly, R effective for the, this is like the general resistor combination. It is R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Or you can use 1 by R effective. The internal resistance R effective is given by 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. Either of these things you can use. No problem, no issues. This formula or this formula. So finally, what we have achieved from this, you can replace this system with a single cell of EMF E, and the equivalent resistance are equivalent in this single EMF E. So this is how you can replace. This is the cell combination network. Okay. Combination network. So that's how you can replace the cell combination network. Okay. Now let's go ahead. So we'll solve some problem, then you will have the feel of solving this. Noted, everyone? Everyone noted this?
Yes.
Okay. Right. And now suppose if one cell is reversed, right? Like the situation I will tell you. It's like this. E1, this E1, and this is R1, and you have another combination that is given by E2, and that is R2. Now it's like this. April, and it's R2. And now you have this one. Now suppose in this combination, suppose I put the fourth one also so that you will have an idea. One cell is taken in reverse. Okay. Now, if I ask you to write the formula for this, the E effective, if I ask you to write. R effective is no problem. 1 by R effective will be like, you can write 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 plus 1 by R4. You can write R effective, no issues on that. So how do you write E effective? It's like this. E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 plus E3 by R3. Why I have written this? You see this? All the positive are connected to one end. All the negative are connected to negatives. Okay. And now this fourth cell, E4, is connected reverse. So that one we will put a negative sign, and E4 by R4 divided by 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 plus 1 by R4. You don't have to do anything for the resistor. Resistor combination will not change. Like what you see in the parallel, four resistors are connected in parallel. So it's like 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R4. That is R equivalent or R effective will be like this. No problem. This calculation is not an issue. But when it comes to the cells, the one which is reversed, that EMF you have to subtract. Okay. In that point of view, we'll solve one problem, then you will understand. So can I clear? This one, once finish it, please let me know. One cell connected reverse. Okay. If one cell is connected in reverse. If one cell is connected in reverse. So this is what when it is done, this is how you can put it. So once finished, please let me know, ma. Please let me know once finished.
Completed, sir.
Good. Let's move on. Now let us solve one question. So find the equivalent EMF and internal resistance. Find the equivalent EMF and internal resistance. So that's a question. So the cells are connected like this. It's a 9 volt battery, internal resistance of 3 ohms. The next one is a 3 volt battery. See this one, this is connected reverse. You have to be careful here. So the internal resistance is also 3 ohm. And now another cell which is connected, that is 6 volts. This is 6 volts. Okay. And internal resistance of 3 ohms only are connected like this. So this is like a 6 volt. Okay. Now they are connected like this in parallel. Now effective EMF we have to calculate. E effective. How do we do that? E1 by R1 plus for this one and this one, no problem. E2 by R2. Now this cell is reversed, right? So it is like E3 by minus E3 by R3 whole divided by 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Let's plug in the values. So E1 is 9 volts divided by R1 is 3 ohms. Okay, plus this one 6 by 3 minus 3 by 3. 3 by 3 because this cell is reversed. Okay, this is negative and positive. All the positive should be in one line and all the negative should be in one line. If that is called a parallel, if one cell is reversed, that should be subtracted. That is the idea. So 1 by 3 plus, 1 by 3 plus, 1 by 3. So R1, R2, R3, they are 3, 3, 3. So 1 by 4, 1 by 3, 1 by 3, 1 by 3. So denominator 1 third plus 1 third plus 1 third, that is 1 anyway. So on the top, you have this is 3, this is 2. This is 1. So this is 3 plus 2 minus 1. That is 4 volts. So effective EMF is 4 volts. Done deal. Now the next one is the effective resistance. So 1 by R effective is 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So it is like 1 third. Plus 1 third plus 1 third. So when you add up, you get 1. So R effective is 1 ohm. So that is the effective resistance and the effective EMF is 4 volts. Hope I'm clear. Once finished, please let me know. Finished.
Yes, sir.
Now let's move on to the next question. Now find the find E equivalent and R equivalent for the given paper. So this is the question. So you have a 6 volt battery and then there is a 1 ohm resistor and now you have a, so it's a combination of both. It's a 10 volt battery and you have a 2 ohm resistor and you have a 4 volt battery and you have a 2 ohm resistor and now you have, this is like this, that's all they have given. And now we have to find the equivalent resistance, okay, and equivalent EMF. And now here let us concentrate on the first part, is this parallel combination will concentrate, and later we'll come to the series. This is a combination of series as well as parallel combination. First let us concentrate on the parallel combination. So here, as per us, this is reverse. No, this is reverse and this is all right. This looks all right and this is reverse. Okay. Okay, we'll put up that. So for this, the E parallel equivalent, a parallel equivalent combination is given by E1 by R1, but we'll put the negative sign because this is being reversed. Okay. This is being reversed. Okay, plus E2 by R2 divided by 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. Can everyone calculate and tell me what it would be? 10 by 2, that is minus 10 by 2 plus this one, E2 by R2, that is 4 by 2, all divided by, this is 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, that is 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. So that E equivalent, you are going to get a very different answer here. So that is minus 5, right? This is minus 5 plus 2, right? Minus 5 plus 2 divided by 1. So that is minus 3 volt. So what does this minus 3 volt specify? It specifies that this entire combination is giving minus 3 volt. With an equivalent resistance, how much? 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, that is anyway 1 ohm. So the equivalent resistance 1 ohm and it is negative 3 volt. Means with respect to 6 volts, that is negative 3 volts. So we'll do that. So don't worry. It means that this is a 6 volt battery and then you have one more 1 ohm resistance and this 3 volt is connected in reverse. That's what it means. Negative 3 volts means it is connected in reverse. So okay. So you got 3 volts that is connected in reverse and then you have a 1 ohm resistor followed by. And now how to handle this combination, that is the final equivalent is E1 plus E2. But this is negative 3 volts. Remember what we got is negative 3 volts. So it is 6 minus 3. That is the equivalent. So in the series combination that simply they will add up. So that is 3 volts is what you are going to get. And the equivalent resistance, R equivalent is here, they are in series. So it is like 1 ohm plus 1 ohm. So it is 2 ohms in total. So that's how to solve the problem. Hope you got it.
Yes, sir.
Can I clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. The next one. Little bit advanced level. If n cells each of EMF E and internal resistance R and internal resistance are connected in parallel, are connected in parallel, are connected in parallel, then what is the equivalent? You have to find E equivalent and R equivalent. This is what the question is. Find the E equivalent and R equivalent. So the situation here, what it says that they are like you have E-R. Okay. So, E and R. They are all connected in parallel. So, this is the situation. E and R. They are all connected in parallel. So, how many cells are connected like this? N cells, right? Getting this, how to draw the N cells? I cannot do that. So, we'll put dot, 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 dot. So, it is like a huge combination of certain cells, certain number of cells, each of EMFP. They are spanning all over like this. So, it is like this. Okay, this is R and this is E. And how to find the E equivalent? There, N cells are connected like this. So, E equivalent will be each of EMFP divided by internal resistance is R. They are identical cells. So, E by R plus E by R like this. How many times it will come? N times. Obvious, right? So, whole divided by you have 1 by R plus 1 by R plus 1 by R. So on up to N times. So we get an interesting thing here. You see, when they are added up, you get N E by R whole divided by N by R. Beautifully, this N by R gets cancelled out. So you will get E. That's it. The answer happens to be E. And now the effective internal resistance. What will be the R effective? R effective will be 1 by R plus 1 by R plus 1 by R, so on up to N times it is coming. So it is N by R. And the R effective will be R by N. So that's the answers for you. Hope it's clear. If anyone having doubt, please ask me. No issues on that. And now in this situation, what is the potential difference we are going to get? E minus R by N. That is the effective potential difference you are going to get. So this is not this. They may ask, they may not ask about this part, but this much you should be able to know. We'll solve another problem. Once finished, we'll solve another problem. Can I clear this?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now, another question we have. Very simple question. So, you have a cells like this. You have a 6-volt battery and internal resistance of 3 ohms. And again, you have another 6-volt battery with an internal resistance of 3 ohms. Once again, you have again another 6-volt battery, the resistance of 3 ohms. So this circuit is coming in combination with a 3-volt and a 1-ohm resistor. 3-volt battery with an internal resistance of 1 ohm. So this is a 3-volt battery. So can you do and find the internal resistance of this one? Everyone, what would be the internal resistance here and the effective EMF? E effective. First, the parallel combination we'll see. What would be the effective parallel combination? it is 6 volt 6 volt 6 volt, identical cells are connected in parallel, that is simply 6 volts, that's it, straight you can write, just now we did, no? So it is straight 6 volts, because identical cells are connected in parallel, you will get one EMF, okay? The internal resistance R internal, R equivalent will be R by N. So there are three resistors in three rows. So it is 3 by 3, it is simply 1 ohm, straight you can write this. And now it, the effective thing is like, you have a 6 volt battery that is connected to 1 ohm, and you have simply a 3 volt battery connected to 1 ohm. This is what effectively what you are going to get. And the EMF what you are going to get is, effective EMF is like, now they are in series, 6 plus 3 that is 9 volt, and the effective resistance what you are going to see is 1 plus 1 that is 2 ohms. Okay, right. I hope clear this one, how to handle this.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. We'll move on to the next type of question. Now listen carefully. M rows of cells. M rows of cells. Each row has N cells. Are there? Okay. M rows of cells are there. Rows means it is like this. Like this. They made M rows. How many? M are there. M rows. Okay. M rows of cells are there. Each row contains N cells. Okay, N cells. Now imagine, you have to imagine there are M rows like this are connected, and each row contains N cells. So it is like N cells with EMF E and internal resistance R. So like this, how many are there? N. So each row is having like this E, R and E and R, like this it goes. So the identical cell network, it's like what they have done is, suppose you take N cells of EMF E and the resistance R like this. So N cells like this, they have made like M rows they have made. Okay, now like this it is going. I hope you understood what I meant. E and R in the series wise, they are N cells. Like this entire network, how many cells do you get? N cells of each row. They are M rows like this. N into M cells are there. So that's what this is, NM cells are there in this network. And now the question is that find, so these are all connected like this in the parallel combination. Okay, these are all connected in the parallel combination. These are all cells like this, connected. Cells like this connected. They are all connected in parallel. Hopefully they are getting this. M cells, they are connected in parallel. The first one is you want to find what is E equivalent. The second one, you have to find what is R equivalent. The third one. And now the third one is like find an external resistor. External resistor. R is connected or is connected to this combination, to this combination. An external resistor R is connected to this combination. Find I and R. You also have to find how much current and how much is the resistor. In terms of combination, find I and R. Find the relation between. Find the relation. Relation between N M smaller and capital R such that I is maximum. Such that I is maximum. And also find I max. This is the question. Also find I max. So I max refers to maximum current what can flow inside the circuit. So this is a situation called mixed grouping. Mixed grouping of cells. So it's like you have the series as well as parallel combination problem within the thing itself. So let us do it slowly. So once finished, please let me know. Once finished writing, I'll redraw the diagram so that you will understand that. Once finished, please let me know.
Yes, sir.
Now we will solve the problem. So it's like I will redraw the circuit so that you will understand. So assume that it is like this. Okay, this is my E and it is having an internal resistance of R. Next again comes an E. And having an internal resistance of R. Like this, how many cells? N cells are there. N cells are there. Okay, right? So the nth cell is like this. Okay, N cells are there. N cells, you keep it in bracket. This cell, this is the last one. It is like this. Okay. Now you will get the original picture. Okay. So here, the same way, same as this one, a replica of this. That's how you have another one. So in between there are so many on there. So okay, like this, this is the row one. Here you may get the row two, row three. There are some rows are there. So here like this, they are all N cells once again connected. It's like this. So those who are having confusion, I hope this will clarify that confusion. It's like this. This is the first row. And you have second row of the same kind. So here you get second row, third row, like this, the same kind of things. Okay, third row, like this, you get the rows. So like this, it extends. The circuit extends like this. You have, I'm just redrawing the circuit so that you will all understand this once again. So it is like this. So like this, you have N cells once again. Here in the last row also, the same kind of N cells are connected until the last row. How many rows are there like this? M rows. Okay. Okay, this is the situation what they have given us in the problem. Hope you understood. Now, can I clear this?
Yes, sir.
Now, let us draw the equivalent circuit for the first row. So how it looks like, N cells, they are connected in series for the first row. So what is the effective EMF? That is NE, because that is a series combination. And then the resistors are connected in series only. So it will be NR. And now followed by the second row, same case, you have NE, NR, right? So like this, you have how many like this? How many like this? M rows, okay. So like this, you have M rows. And now M rows of the cells, which are having, each cell having NE, so the effective resistance will be simply NE. We just calculated. So how, we can calculate that one also, it's not an issue. E effective, you can do that. You can do that. E effective is given by E1 by R1, so NE by NR, you can start doing that, plus NE by NR, so that you have to do for M times, okay, M times you have to do the same, okay, so whole divided by, you have 1 by NR plus 1 by NR plus 1 by NR, if you start doing, how many times you have to do? M times. So when you do that, so this formula you have to use. You have to use this formula. You have to know how to use this. So E effective is given by, so they are added for M times. No, so M divided by NR you have into 1 by, this is M by NR. Because it is added for M times. No, so it is M by NR. So you see, M by NR is cancelled. So you are left with NE. So the first part is effective EMF part is over. That is the first part of the problem. Effective EMF part is NE. That part is over. Is this clear? First part. And what will be the effective resistance, R effective, that we have to find out. So it is 1 by R effective is nothing but M by NR. So when you add up all these things, what you are going to get? M by NR. That is the effective resistance. So the effective resistance is, you have to invert this. That is NR by M. That is the effective resistance. Now, is this done? Clear? Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Now, I'll clear this all. Now, the scenario, the next one is that we have the, now, will reduce the entire circuit into one single thing. They said the load resistor R is connected in series, and again you have the EMF of the combination is what we got is NE with an with a internal resistance of NR by M. This is what. And now, because of this, what is the potential difference felt at the resistor R? It is NE minus NR by M. NR by M is the potential difference felt at that resistor R. Assume the current in the circuit is I into R. So V equal to IR, the potential difference is this NE minus NR by M. Because of the internal resistance, there is a drop in the potential. So that's what we see. So from this, that is I into E minus IR, no? So I into NR by M. So now the calculation has to be NE is equal to I into NR by M plus IR. And now let's take the I out. When I take the I out, I get NR by M plus R. So I have to find I. So let us take the LCM, I into NR plus MR whole divided by M. So I need to calculate what is I. I happens to be M you transport inside, that is NEM divided by, or you can write NME divided by NR plus MR, NR plus MR. N smaller plus capital R. So this is the situation. Now they ask the maximum current. For maximum current situation, to get the maximum current, NR is equal to MR. This is the situation. For maximum current, this is situation. There is a mathematics behind that. Don't worry too much about that. But you will get the maximum current when NR equal to MR. Remember that. So once you substitute NR is equal to MR, then you have NR equal to MR. So we will write for what is smaller, you can substitute one of the things, you can substitute over here and then you can see what happens. So I max is, if I substitute MR, instead of NR, I will substitute MR, what happens is that NME divided by MR plus MR. So it will be 2MR, NME divided by 2MR. So MM gets cancelled. So it is NE by 2R. In terms of the load resistor, this is how it is. And now in terms of the internal resistance, this is I max. The maximum current you can draw in circuit when NR is equal to MR. This is the combination. This is the condition. For maximum current, this is the condition. Condition for the maximum current, this is the one. And now you have the another thing, I max you can do instead of NR, you substitute MR here, you put NR here. So what happens is that NME divided by NR plus NR. So you have NME whole divided by 2NR. So NN gets cancelled. So I max happens to be how much amount? So ME divided by 2 smaller. This is in terms of the internal resistance, this is in terms of the external resistance. So this is what you have. Okay, you can make a note of this one. I'll take some water and I'll just wait a minute. Please be note. Please note. Please stop. Start noting. I'll come back and I'll start the electric power. Just a minute. Hello. Yeah, anyone having doubts about this or fully doubt or whatever, no problem. Is that okay? Or it's very complicated? A bit complicated, I know. Other noted?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Now we see something called bulb type problems. There are some other type of problems are there. They're called bulb type problems. Bulbs. So to understand the bulbs, we have to deal with the concept of electric power. Electric. What is this electric power? And energy. Electric power and energy. This is the concept what we have to do. Now, what is the job of the cell? A cell will drive. What is the job of the cell? That is the wonder. What is the job of a cell? So how does the cell work? Or it can be a question like, how does the cell work? So this is a fundamental question, but anyway, this is important. A cell will drive the charge. Will drive the charge. Cell will drive the charge and gives energy. And gives energy to the charge to move. So this is the fundamental idea about what is the job of the cell. Means like, what does the cell do? So the next point is what you have to understand is that power. So So there are certain formulas you need to remember. Power is equal to volt into current, means voltage times potential difference times current. So it is like volt into amps. Okay, volt into amps. That is what you get. The units wise, it will come out as joule second, which is watt. Watts. That's a unit. Unit wise, it's that. So voltage into current, that is volt into amps, units. These are the units we are playing with. Units, joule second inverse, that is what? Joule per second, that is what? So for example, a 12 volt battery is there and it is supplying a 2 amps current. So suppose a situation we consider like this, a 12 volt battery, it's able to supply 2 amps current within the circuit, right? So that situation, you can calculate the power. The power will be 12 into 2, that is 24 joule second inverse or 24 watts. This is how we calculate the power. This is a basic calculation of power. Once clear, please let me know.
Yes, sir.
Now, the next one we'll do power dissipated. Power dissipated in resistor. Always remember, power is always dissipated in the resistor. Power, so this is very important. Power is always dissipated, means lost. Okay, always dissipated in the resistor. So some other formulas what you need is power dissipated is power dissipated. This is the heading, power dissipated in the resistor. The power dissipated is given by V into I. The next is I square. You know that V equal to IR. So IR we can put I into R into I. So that is I square R. This is the next. And now another thing is I, you can put V by R. That is another thing you can use. V into V by R. So you get V square by R. These are some of the formulas which you need in order to solve some problem. So this is this connection you have to understand. V square by R, V into I, I square into R. This is power. So this relation is very, very important in solving the problems related to the bulbs. And next, followed by the formula energy, E is equal to potential difference into current into time. This is calculation for energy. Energy dissipated or energy supplied. This formula is valid. This formula is valid only when there is constant current. The above formula for energy is valid only for the constant current. So the other things. Please note these things. Now we have some small problems. Can I clear this one? Is this clear? Everyone, can I go ahead?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. No,
yes, sir.
Yeah. So we'll solve some simple problems. Now, there is a circuit. There is a 2-ohm resistor, and the current of 3 amps is passing through. 3 amps current is passing through for a time of 3 seconds. For a time of 3 seconds, it is possible. Now calculate the power and energy. You have to calculate the power and energy. How to calculate power? Power is nothing but I square R. One of the relation you have used. V into I. Here R is given and current is given. So I square R. So I square means 9, that is current is 3 amps, so I square is 9 into 2, so that is 18 watt, right? Now energy is VIT, this is one way, or I square RT, this is the other way. So I square is 9 into 2, it is passed for 3 seconds. So we'll put 3 to this, right? 9654 joules. Clear? Is this clear?
Yes.
No. The next one, next question is about a variable current. How, if variable current is coming, how to solve such questions? So this is the situation of variable current. I is equal to 2t. And now, and the time is t is equal to 2 seconds they have given. That means current is passed from t is equal to 0 seconds to t is equal to 2 seconds. For 2 seconds it is passed. Okay. And now this the resistor is 2-ohm resistor. Now in this case you got to calculate what is the energy and power. Okay. The power part is we can do not much we can do, but the energy power is varying part here. So it is I square R, right? So it is I square into R. So it is 2t whole square 2t whole square into r, that is 2. So it is 4t square into 2, 8t square. Right? Hope I'm right. 8t square. That is power. But what they asked in this problem is actually energy only. They didn't ask you about the power, energy. So how to calculate energy? Energy is equal to integral p dt. Remember this. Integral p dt from time t1 to t2. Integral p dt from time t1 to t2. So here time, it is passing from 0 seconds to 2 seconds. So integral 0 to 2 seconds. The power we have calculated is 8t square. 8t square. Dt simply. So integral p dt. Remember this one? So t square integration is t cube by 3. So 8 by 3 into t cube under the limits 0 to 2. So it happens to be 8 by 3. 2 cube is 8. So it is 64 by 3 joules. That's the answer for you. Clear? Hope I'm clear. If variable current is given, this is how you have to apply. Energy is given by integral p dt. I told you that earlier formula, energy is dit. This is valid only for constant current. Constant current. Only for constant current, this formula is valid. Otherwise, it's not valid. Okay. For variable current, how do we do that? Can I clear? Once finished, I'll do that. Yes. I'll clear this. Once finished, please let me know. Is this clear? I hope I'm clear with this one. I'll again write the formula. So once you finish with this, I'll go to the formula. Once again, I'll tell you the formula. Oh, is it finished? Can I go ahead?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Fine. Now the next one is power and energy. How they are connected? If there is a variable current, energy is given by integral p dt under the limits t1 to t2. This is applicable when variable current or variable potential difference are provided. Okay. Are provided as a function of time. As a function of time. So depending upon the problem, you got to solve. It will be, I will tell you this, based on this, I will tell you definite one question will be there in your exam. One question is for sure. Definite one question. Please be sure, ensure that cells and bulbs. Now bulbs are coming into that. They'll ask you about the bulbs. It's very important. What is the bulb? What is the situation? Bulb is what? Rating of the bulbs, all these things we are going to discuss in short. Is this finished? I hope it's finished. We'll go ahead. Next, what is that? Is bulbs. So we have, you have to understand one thing, like if I say a 100 watt bulb, the 100 watt bulb refers to, see, they have given this much only. They have not spoken anything about the current or something. 100 watt bulbs refers to, it will dissipate, it dissipates. What is this? This is called bulb rating, okay? Bulb rating. If the bulb is rated 100 watts, it refers to that it will dissipate dissipate 100 watts when it is, it refers to bulb. When the bulb is connected to a supply of 220 volts. So this is what you have to remember. If it is connected to a supply of 220 volts, then you would say that the bulb is 100 watts. If less than 220 volts, the bulb is connected. It glows dim. It will not glow with full potential. It will glow dim. Okay, this is what you have to understand. Okay. Now the question is all the time, once the rating is provided to you, you got to find the resistance of the bulb. Now the next question, once this is clear, please let me know. And you can say that brightness of the bulb is proportional to the power. Brightness of the bulb is proportional to the power. So once finished, please let me know.
Yes, sir.
Now the question is that resistance, the next part is that finding the resistance of the bulb. Resistance of bulb based on power rating. So it's easy only, don't have to do much. Let us say the power rating is given as 100 watts. So the power is 100 watts, like that will take. Now I have to find the resistance. We know that P is equal to V square by R. Now the 100 ratings, 100 watt bulb means it is connected to a potential difference of 220 volts. You have to remember this. This is a standard formula. And now the power is, what do we substitute? 100 watts is equal to 220 volts. 220 volts, that is 220 whole square divided by R. So how do we find the R? R is equal to 220 into 220. Okay. Divided by 100. Right. So when you calculate, you get about 484 ohms. Okay, Now you got the resistance of the bulb. This is what? Resistance of bulb. So this is how you calculate the resistance of the bulb. Clear? In all the cases we use to find the resistance of the bulb. So the funda is to find resistance of the bulb. Resistance of the bulb. In all the cases, we use V is equal to 220 volts. In all the cases, we use V is equal to 220 volts. Am I clear? I hope I am clear.
Yes.
Okay. Now, let's move on. The next one is that. So, the question, let's solve one question. A bulb of 100 watt rating is connected to a 110 volts power supply. Calculate the power dissipated. Okay, calculate the power dissipated. Calculate the power dissipated. So here the situation bulb will be drawn like this. Hope you all know it will be drawn like this. Okay. It will be drawn like this. So here they have given the rating of the bulb is 100 watt. Okay. So first job is to find the resistance of the bulb. How do you find the resistance? So P1 is V square by R. Always use to find the resistance of the bulb. Always use V equal to 220. V is 220 volts, and you have the power rating. From the power rating, you have that is 100 watts. So we have just found the resistor 484 ohms. I am not solving that because we solved just now. We got the resistance. After this, I need to find what is the power dissipated. So that is the second case. So in the second case, it is connected to 110 volt supply. So it is like V square by R I can use, right? Once again, but this time V is how much? 110 volts. So 110 into 110 whole divided by 484. Okay. So it actually goes 11 times 44. So it is 44 once again here. So it is like you have this is 11 tens and 11 fours once again, right? So this is now on the top. So it will be 25, okay? 25 watts. Calculate that's 25 watts. Clear? So that is the power dissipated when it is connected to 110 volts power supply. So this is how you have to solve. And one more important thing is that the resistance of the bulb, remain constant during all the connections, the resistance of the bulbs remain constant. Now, a very famous question will solve. Once finished, please let me know.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we have very famous question. Just running. Three bulbs. Very important. This kind of questions may come in your exam. Three bulbs. 1, 2, 3. You can mark it like 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 are connected in series with a 220 volt power supply. A 220 volt power supply. Supply as shown in the figure. As shown in the figure. Now, which is the brightest one? Which will glow brighter? Or the other type of question is order of brightness. Order of brightness. So here the situation is like this. You have the first bulb. This is the first one, first bulb one is 100 watt. Bulb one is 100 watt bulb. And this is the bulb two. The bulb two is 50 watt. And again, you have the third bulb. Third bulb. And that's bulb three. The bulb three is about 25 watt. Okay. It's like this. And now you have, it's connected to a huge, huge 220 volt power supply. Now this is the situation what is given to you. All the three bulbs are given in series. Okay, right? And now which is the brightest in the order of brightness? So if the options are given like this, the options is 1 > 2 > 3. Option B, 1 > 3 > 2. Option C, 3 > 2 > 1. Okay. The option D is 2 > 1 > 3. So I'll tell you the right answer now itself so that you will not have any problem later. Option C, the 25 watt bulb will glow brighter. Don't think it's a 100 watt bulb will glow brighter here. It's a 25 watt bulb will glow brighter. Why we'll see? It's 25 watt bulb will glow brighter. Why it is so, we are going to see now. Now, the first thing is that, so once you have noted this, we'll solve this problem. Once you have noted the stuff. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now let's calculate the resistances. So R1, the first case of resistance. So we use V square by P1. So directly P1, you know that we calculated power is V square by R. So if I write for P1, this R1. So R1 happens to be V square by P1. So what is V square? That is 220 whole square, whole divided by the first bulb is of 100 watts. So when you calculate, that is 484 ohms. And now let's calculate the second case. The second case is again V square by P2. The second case is 50 watt. So it is 220 whole square, whole divided by 50. When you calculate that, you will end up with 2 times 484. So it is how much amount it will be? 2 times 484, that is 8, 16, right? 16, so it will be 6. So 2 plus 8, 968. So it is 968. 968. And now R3 is how much amount? V square by P3. So it will be 220 whole square, whole divided by 25. Can you calculate and tell me? This will be like 4 times 484. It will come out. Okay. So double of 968. 968, let's put that 16, 6 plus 6, 12, 13. So 1936 ohms. So this is what we got. So the power rating is lower means the resistance is really high, which means that you have the situation R3 is greater than R2 is greater than R1. This is a series combination. So the current, if I multiply with I square on either side, I square R3 is greater than I square R2 is greater than I square R1. We got this. You know, what does it mean? It's like, it says that, so this is the power of the first, the third one is more than that of the rest of the things. So you got P3 greater than P2 is greater than P1. This is the order you want. Which means that, what is the inference? The third bulb will glow brighter. So the brightness order is like this. This is the brightness order. Brightness order is the third bulb which will glow brighter. Hope I'm clear. This is about the bulb problems, little bit about the bulb problems. So many kinds of bulb problems will be there. This kind of things do come. So this is meant for the series problems. This is meant for the series problems. This is meant for the series combination. For the series combination, the larger the resistance, more the brightness. Please understand, this is only meant for series combination. Larger, okay, is that fine? The brightness order, what we have written is for the series combination. Please understand, for the parallel combination, we are equivalent. We'll do for the parallel combination. Why it is like that? Why we have multiplied with I square is current is constant in series. So for a series combination, the power rating is less, that will be more brighter. So I'll rewrite, we'll rewrite this. Once finished, please let me know. This is finished. Clear. Once finished, please let me know. Is this clear, Amma? Can I go ahead?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next one is bulbs in path. So earlier, what I did was bulbs in series, now bulbs in path. So what if I connect the same kind of stuff? It's like you have a 100 watt bulb and you have the same things. Okay, you have a 50 watt bulb and you have a 25 watt bulb. Okay, you have a 25 volt. So all these things are connected in parallel now. So this is the situation, they are connected in parallel for the same 220 volt power supply. They are connected to the same 220 volt power supply. Okay, clear? Hope we are clear for you. Now, which one is more brighter? So parallel and series, they will be different. So we have to analyze here how it will turn out. So we have calculated, this is the first, we'll call it as the first bulb, second bulb, and third bulb. So we all know that for the parallel combination, potential remains constant. Potential V remains constant in parallel combination. Okay, right. Remains constant. So in all the three cases, we know that very well. The R1 is 484 ohms. We just calculated now, so I'm not doing the same calculation. R2 is 2 times 484 ohms. And R3 is 4 times 484 ohms. We just calculated this. And now you all know that R3 is greater than R2 is greater than R1. So we will invert this. When I invert it, the inequality signs will change. Inequality will be reversed. So when I write 1 by R3 is less than 1 by R2 is less than 1 by R1. That equality signs will be reversed if I topple the fraction. Now, after this, what I have to do is, since you see this, V remains constant. I cannot multiply with the current. So, when I multiply with V square, so V square by R3 is less than V square by R2 is less than V square by R1. You may get a doubt. Sir, here itself, why can't I multiply with V? This is the formula for power. V square by R is the formula for power. So I need to see in terms of the power. So 1 by R1 type of combination I need. And why I am taking voltage here is the reason that in the parallel combination, you have voltage remains constant. For the series combination, we have multiplied with I square. The reason behind that is that I remains constant in the series combination. So here you have, you see this one, this is P3 less than P2 less than P1, which means that higher, the 100 watt bulbs glows brighter. The 100 watts bulb glows brighter here. Glows brighter. So for a series combination, we can write one simple thing is that smaller the resistance, smaller resistance, smaller the resistance, more brightness. For which combination? For a parallel combination.
See.
Parallel combination. So for a series combination, how do you get this?
More
the resistance, more the brightness. So these are the basic fundamental aspects which you have to keep in mind while working with the bulbs. So if I am clear with the things, next week, that would be the bulbs I have finished. If you have any more questions about the bulbs, please let me know if you come across. The next week is about the meter bridge, voltmeter, and what else is there? Conversion of galvanometer into voltmeter, potentiometer, voltmeter, and ammeter. Okay. How a galvanometer can be converted, shunt resistance, a little bit about the aspects will come. Am I clear? Everyone got it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. We'll close it today. Sufficient. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you all.